Hi, I'm glad you're here. Have I got something to show you? Today we're at the Toronto Vintage Bicycle Show, and I thought it was going to be all bicycles, but as long as it's vintage and you've got two wheels, they've got you covered.
Now we're riding along on the bicycle, honey. That's a bicycle built for two. I'm looking at my honey in the rearview mirror.
I'm with Adrian of the Community Bicycle Network. Adrian, can you tell us about your event today?
Well, our event is the Toronto Vintage Bicycle Show. It's a shine and show. We encourage people to bring out their vintage bikes if they're hiding in the basement or their garage, shine them up, and show it off to the world. We do this every year to celebrate bike culture. We want to get people interested and excited in riding their bicycles. It's not always about activism and bike lanes and, you know, fighting against the mayor. No, it's about fun. I'm looking at a couple of penny farthings over there, and for people to see the high wheels walking through the park or slipping along the sidewalk, that's history right there.
What's going on or what happened, asking questions.
Greg, can you give us a demo of the radio bike?
Sure, it's a 57 Huffy radio bike. Tuner, knob, volume control.
27 degrees with a humidex of 33.
It was 1 year only, and they're kind of a rare bike, and I believe every child in the US of A wanted to own one.
But you'll look sweet upon the seat of a bicycle built for two.
I'm with Roger. Roger, can you tell us about some of the bikes that you have? I assume they are the oldest of the bikes that are here today?
Correct. Starting 1865 period, the Bone Shakers would have been the first bikes with pedals on them. Next would have been 1870s to about 90 was in England called the penny farthing. North America actually called them the high wheel or an ordinary. Within that same period, they made what's called a safety of that version of an ordinary, which was the star or the eagle. The eagle had the pedals, star has the action. And the bike on the end is a child's tricycle. Fairy was one of the larger brands out there.
And so I gather you own all of these bikes?
I do, yes, and many more.
This is a 40-year-old Schwinn frame, a hybrid with modern technology. As you can see, the bike is self-propelled. Does 50 kilometers per hour. Not that I do that, of course. Retrofitted with disc brakes, but I've gone for the board track racer look of the early 1900s. It's a new hobby, but I didn't think it would generate this much interest, to be honest with you. Who knows where it'll go? Yeah, it's definitely a labor of love.
I'm with Chris from Detroit Cargo. Chris, can you tell us about your products here today?
So we've got a line of handmade leather bags for bicycles. We've got some larger frame bags that will fit your tablet or small computer, laptop, and some other items when you're riding your bike. We also have some other items like belts and wallets and some recycled fire hose wallets that from abandoned buildings in downtown Detroit, and a lot of the dyes that are used, or all the dyes that are used to stamp these leather products are made by, you know, companies that formerly supplied the automotive industry in Detroit and are out of work and are looking to diversify and do other things in their factory.
The low rider is a little higher.
I was attracted over to this bike because it's red, and that's my favorite color, and Bill said that it suited me. Then we got to talking, and I wanted to find out about this beauty.
This bike, I bought it as a very dilapidated old piece from my friend's backyard. So I purchased it, and I strip it right down to bare metal, and I refinish it. They have the biggest fenders of any vintage bikes. Love me, honey, back like I love you.
Have their location, and what do you do at the shop?
Well, we're at 761 Queen Street West. We're located in a beautiful church over by Euclid, and we do a lot of community-oriented things. We sell used bicycles, we do repairs, we do workshops, we do programming, we sell parts that people have trouble finding. Basically anything that has to do with bicycles, we do it, because we just want people to get out, get into the shop, get a flat tire fix for $11, get their brakes tuned for, you know, for $15 in 15 minutes. Make it easy for people to get on their bikes and get back on the road.
Hey.